Do you think you'll have enough money to live off when you've retired? Well, superannuation might not be high on your list of priorities. Don't zone out yet because it should be. Finance expert Noel Whittaker joins us now on how to make our superannuation super simple and work for us. Welcome to the show.
Hey. Good morning. Nice to be back. Good morning. Good morning.
Now, look, super is not a very sexy topic, but it is so important, Noel. Why does it have such an image problem, do you think?
I think because they keep changing the rules.
Yes.
And the major finding was 80% of people are disengaged.
Yep.
They'd rather do the football tips and everything else.
Yep.
And really, it's quite simple.
Is it?
If you take the time.
Is it really?
Can you make it simple for us? Because I'm one of those people who just, I can understand most everything in the world, but superannuation just...
Okay.
Come.
If I told you you could move to Hong Kong with a tax rate 15%, you'd say, take me there.
Yes.
Any money in super moves to a 15%. Any money in super moves to a 15% tax area. And you can make it with contributions with pre-tax dollars.
So make your voluntary superannuation contributions as high as possible. Is that what
you should put as much as you possibly can into super.
And the big news is since June 30th, everybody can claim a tax deduction for extra contributions.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
No, there's actually a list of important things to remember about super that you're going to run us through now.
It'll be a big list.
Some of those, yeah. So your top one is that super is the only investment you can make before tax dollars?
Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
So that means none of that gets touched by the tax man. You take all your gross income before they tax it, and you're basically making an extra 30 to 40 cents in the dollar.
And where that's important, if you're, say, 55 and you're paying off a mortgage, to get paid and lose, say, 40% tax in your pay packet, you've got less money than if you make the extra payments into super and lose 15% tax, and then pay your mortgage back when you retire from the extra superannuation money.
Wow. Okay.
All those other tips. I'll just grab that graphic back up on the screen now.
Yeah.
Super's not an asset like property. It's a low-tax investment. How much you have in retirement depends on the rates you achieve. How do
Absolutely.
You achieve higher rates?
Okay. You need to know what sort of assets your fund invests in. And that number two, what we're talking about it's a box, not a asset. Whenever the share market falls, papers say billions wiped off superannuation.
Yes.
But if you had those shares outside super, you'd still be losing the same amount. So super is just a box that lets you hold, just like a box, that lets you hold cash, property and shares in a low tax area. And if you go broke, it's the only thing they can't get off you.
Ooh.
What's hard, though, I was with my accountant yesterday, which was very scary news. And I think as a woman...
He'll save your money.
He'll save your money. I feel like it cost me money. But anyway.
Tax deductible, too.
I had my eyes glaze over. But as a woman who you go in and out of the career force and I have children and I freelance, and it's very hard to say, I'm going to put that money aside for my future, even though I know it's important. I feel like, this week's whatever is more important. So it's something that's very important
to do. So the next good news, the next new thing is catch-up contributions, because you're allowed $25,000 a year tax deductible, but if this year or next year you can't make those contributions, as long as your balance is under $500,000, you could potentially put in $75,000. So the catch-up contributions is designed for you.
Oh, okay.
But you really got to get into the habit of saving, don't you?
You got to.
Yeah.
And I found that the only way to save is you save first. And that's why having superannuation taken out of your pay packet is all
that matters.
You don't
notice it.
Because you don't miss what you don't get.
And is that easy to set up? Is it easy to...
Oh, yeah. Ask your boss, of course, yeah. Mm. Yeah. But the only drawback is money in super can't be accessed until you're 60.
Hang on a second.
Sorry.
Some of us in this profession... I went through it when I was 50 and signed all the papers so that if I got to a stage where I wasn't working, I could access super.
Yes, that would have been called a transition to retirement pension, possibly.
Yes.
Well, that's changed. A little bit complex, I think, for here this morning. But
Okay. What about we're hearing about first-time home buyers?
It's a terrible idea.
To access your super.
Well, okay. The major goal, if you're in super, is get the highest return possible. The major goal for a home borrower is get the lowest rate possible. They're totally incompatible.
Talk about life insurance, because you can take a life insurance policy out through your super fund, can't you? A lot of people don't know that.
Yes, and by taking it through your super fund, you get to pay it with pre-tax dollars. But what you need to be very, very careful of, if you move super funds, you can lose your life insurance. Now, yes. A case recently, right. The guy got diagnosed with terminal cancer. His wife said, I will save fees, I'll amalgamate the funds.
Oh, no.
And amalgamated the one fund that carried the 400,000 life insurance, and they lost it.
Mm. Oh.
So it's critical.
Can I just say one thing about life?
No, it's critical too.
It's critical if you're moving insurance and changing funds, not to lose that life insurance.
No. Is there some sort of red flag that goes off before that happens? Like, how are you meant to know all this stuff? I mean, it's buried in a billion pages of small print.
No, it's in a little tiny book. Small. Look at that. Hey. It's simple.
Okay, I feel like I need this.
You can have it. I'll even sign it for you.
Do you have a quick question for Noel?
I do. I feel life insurance... I don't believe in it because I believe that we're here, whatever assets we leave for our kids is enough without giving them another lot of money.
Yeah, but if you've got debt, the life insurance, if you've got debt and you die early, heaven forbid, you don't want to leave your family or your children with that debt. Yes. So if you have a policy, they can pay off your debts with the policy.
Okay.
Young man, a young family with kids.
We've got life insurance through our superannuation as well.
Absolutely.
So if I get knocked off, it's
Tom's fault. Look at Joe's face. Joe's face is
over. That's right, yeah.
You're not sure, have you?
I'm not sure if I want to take out life insurance because my wife gets very cross at me sometimes.
You get her off to McDonald's.
Is there a magic number that we should retire on? What should we be aiming for? What should we have in the bank by the time we retire?
Oh, I think the average couple, they say, needs about $55,000 a year.
Yeah.
Right.
And the average single, maybe 35 to 40. But it depends on the
wine
you drink and how much you travel. Right.
And the pension only pays something like 17...
The pension's $34,000 for a couple.
Oh, okay. Right.
So and there is a sweet spot that they talk about. If you've got $400,000 and you've got $800,000, the increase in pension that the lower person gets is more than the other person earns on their super.
Ah.
Because every $100,000 of extra assets costs you $8,000 of pension.
Right.
Right. So.
But do you think there's going to be a pension in years to come?
Oh, well, look, Australia's borrowing $1 billion every month. It can't go on forever.
No.
Well, you can read all about superannuation in Superannuation Made Simple. Noel Whittaker, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much.